Good morning, friends. Welcome to the third practice session of Algebric Expression. Myself, Dinesh Miglani. This is a very useful session for the students who are going for SSC pre and mains examination. You may connect me on my Facebook @ Dinesh Miglani. My WhatsApp number 092-155-14435. My email ID legalbuddy@gmail.com. You may send my email for any query. For regular updates of my videos, you may subscribe to YouTube channel @ Dinesh Miglani. I expect from you to share these videos on your Facebook wall as well as send the links to your friends so that more and more people will be benefited by this. Let us start with the first question of this session. It is given that root x plus 1 upon root x equal to 5. We have to find x square plus 1 by x square, right? So first of all, I need x plus 1 by x square in both sides. X plus 1 by x plus 2 equal to 25. So from here I can say x plus 1 by x equal to 23, right? Now I have to find x square plus 1 by x square, again squaring both sides. So what you will get? X square plus 1 by x square plus 2 equal to 529. The answer is said to be 527. That becomes your answer. Hence I can say first is my answer, 527. Let us have the second question. X plus 1 by x equal to 3. We have to find x raised to power 4 plus 1 by x raised to power 4. Squaring it, x square plus 1 by x square plus 2 equal to 9. It means x square plus 1 by x square equal to 7. Although we can do the things in our mind. For explaining you, I am just stating here. Then again, I have to make the square 49 minus 2, 47. Right, hence I can say 4th is my answer. Answer is said to be 47. It is given that x plus 1 by x is 2.5. We have to find x raised to power 4 plus 1 by x raised to power 4. Squaring both sides, you can say x square plus 1 by x square plus 2. That is equal to 2.5 square 6.25 minus 2. So I can say 4.25. Right? Again, squaring both sides. So here you can say x raised to power 4 plus 1 by x raised to power 4. This would be taken as 4.25 whole square minus 2. Right? Now what I can say, I know that I have to make the square of 425, 5 square is 25, right? And I have to multiply 42 into 43, you can say 3 to the 6, 12, 8, 20 0 carry to 16 or to 18, right? You are getting to be 180625, it should be 18.0625 minus 2, right? So I can say 16.0625, that becomes your answer. Hence I can say second is my answer, 16.0625. Let us have the next question here. Y minus z cube plus z minus x cube plus x minus y cube is equal to, we know that if I take this to be A, this to be B, this to be C, A cube plus B cube plus C cube. We know that if A plus B plus C is equal to 0, in that case A cube plus B cube plus C cube is always equal to 3ABC. That means, because when I add y minus z, z minus x and x minus y, sum is equal to 0. Hence I can say this is equal to thrice of y minus z, z minus x and x minus y. Hence I can say third is my answer. The answer to this question is said to be third one, 3 times of y minus z into z minus x into x minus y. Let us have the next question. 5x minus 3 by x, 5y minus 3 by y, 5z minus 3 by z equal to 0. We have to find that. So what I can say, I just make them individual. So this is 5x by x, 5 minus 3 by x, similarly, plus 5 minus 3 by y, plus 5 minus 3 by z. This is equal to 0. All values goes there. I can say 15 equal to 3 times of 1 by x plus 1 by y plus 1 by z. Okay, so from here I can say 1 by x plus 1 by y plus 1 by z equal to 5. Hence I can say 5 becomes my answer. Here answer to my question is first one, that is said to be 5. Let us have the next question here. It is given that x equal to a divided by b minus c, y equal to b by c minus a, z equal to c by a minus b. I have to find this value, right? What I know that, I can simply say that x upon a would be taken as b minus c cube. That we can say that is said to be b minus c cube, right? So here I can put b minus c cube plus plus C minus AQ plus A minus BQ, right? I have to find this value. Now I know that, let us say this is MNO, MN cube, MQ plus NQ plus OQ. That is always equal to 3MNO, where their sum is equal to 0. When I add these 3, then I am getting that the sum is equal to 0, right? Hence I can say this would be taken as 3 times of B minus C into C minus A into A minus B, right? Now I know that B minus C would be taken as X upon A. This is X upon A, this is Y upon B, this is Z upon C, right? Hence I can say my answer is said to be 3 X, Y, Z upon A, B, C, okay? Here my answer is said to be, third is my answer, 3 times of X, Y, Z by A, B, C, that becomes my answer. Let us have the next question here. It is given that if the square root of X is cube root of Y, square root of X equal to cube root of Y, I have to find out which is the true association. Here power is 1 by 2, here 1 by 3. Make power 6 both sides. So I get here X cube equal to Y square. Just check out from the option. So I can say first is my answer. The correct association between X and Y is first one, X cube equal to Y square. Let us have the next question. It is given that X plus 1 by X is equal to 2. Earlier I also told you that in any question, if you have X plus 1 by X is equal to 2, that is only possible when X is equal to 1, right? If X is equal to 1, so I can put here 1, so 1 plus 1, 2. Hence, I can say second is my answer. That's my answer. Next question is X minus 1 upon X equal to 5. And I need X raised to power 4 plus 1 upon X raised to power 4, squaring both sides. You get it as X square plus 1 upon X square minus 2 equal to 25, that becomes 27. Again, squaring both sides, X raised to power 4 plus 1 by X raised to power 4 plus 2 equal to 729. So I can say 729 minus 2, this is equal to 727. Hence, I can say first is my answer, 727. Next question is, it is given that X minus 1 by X equal to 3. We have to find X cube plus 1 by X cube. Now, I know that for finding the value of X cube plus 1 by X cube, first I need X plus 1 by X. For that, what I can say, squaring both sides, X square plus 1 by X square equal to 11. Because 3 square is 9 and 2 will go this side, that is 11, right? Now I need X plus 1 by X whole square, add 2 both sides. X plus 1 by X is said to be root 13, that you can say. Because if I add 2 here and 2 here, so I am getting that X plus 1 by X whole square equal to 13. So I can say X plus 1 by X is said to be root 13, right? Now cubing both sides, A cube plus B cube plus 3 into A into B into A plus B equal to root 13 raised to power 3, right? Now this is cancelled out, so I can say X cube 1 by X cube is equal to 13 root 13 minus 3 root 13, okay? So finally I can say 10 root 13 becomes my answer, right? So I can say that first is my answer is said to be 10 root 13, okay? The next question here is 7x minus 7 by 2x is equal to 14. I have to find out x cube minus 1 by 8x cube. Take 7 outside, you get it as x minus 1 by 2x is equal to 2. Now cubing both sides, a cube minus b cube minus 3 into a into b divided by a minus b. Okay, 2 cube is equal to 8. Now this is cancelled out. So I can say x cube minus 1 upon 8x cube. Here it is minus 3 by 2 into 2 equal to 8. 2 is cancelled out. So I can say 8 plus 3 is 11. Hence I can say 4th is my answer. My answer is said to be 11. Next question here is x square plus 4y square plus z square plus 3 equal to 2x plus 4y plus 2z. We have to find x plus y plus z. Bring all values here. So I may say here that x square plus 2x, take 1 here. Similarly, we can say that 4y square plus 4y plus 1, and here I can say z square minus 2z, let us say, sorry, it should be minus, right? It should be minus here, right? And it should be minus plus 1. This is equal to 0, the same concept. Now, this is taken as x minus 1 whole square This is taken as 2y minus 1 whole square, and this is taken as z minus 1 whole square. This is equal to 0. Now we know one very simple thing, because here all powers are even, right? It means this is positive, this is positive, this is positive. When we add three positive numbers, sum is equal to 0. It means all number must be positive, all number must be zeros, x must be 1, y is equal to 1 by 2, and z is equal to 1, right? So what I have to find out, x plus y plus z, 1 plus 1 plus 1 by 2, hence I can say, my answer is said to be 2, 1 by 2, third is my answer, right? Here I can say, the x plus y plus z is equal to 2, 1 by 2. Next question here is, x equal to 2 plus root 3, we have to find this value, right? Now I know that when x is equal to 2 plus root 3, if I just, so I may say 1 by x is equal to 1 by 2 plus root 3, or which in can be stated as 2 minus root 3, because when you multiply by 2 minus root 3 and divide by 2 minus root 3, finally you get it as 2 minus root 3, okay? Now when I look at my question, so what is given to me? X raised to power 6 plus x raised to power 4 plus x square plus 1 divided by x cube, right? I have to answer it. Now what I can say, if I just try to solve it, I may take some values as common. Like for example, if I take x raised to power 5 as common, or I can say out of that, if I say x raised to power 2 as common, right, or if I take x cube, that would be 1 by x, that I am not, what I can say, if I take x outside here, and here if I take x raised to power 5 outside, inside I will get x plus 1 by x, and here if I take x, I will get it as x plus 1 by x, right? But problem here is, with that, we cannot answer anything, because only x would be cancelled out, right? For that, what we can say, we have to somewhere look at this. If I take x raised to power 4 outside, from here, I am getting to be x square plus 1 by x square. Similarly, if I take x square outside, I am getting to be x square plus 1 by x square. That we can say, that could be stated by us. Right, or the better is, instead of going by that, just divide x cube by whole expression. So what you get, this is x raised to power 3 plus x plus 1 by x plus 1 by x cube. Now these two could be made individualized, x cube plus 1 by x cube, right, and this is x plus 1 by x. Now I think it would be easily answered, because x you have 2 plus root 3 and 1 by x is 2 minus root 3. By using both, you can easily answer it, right? So, with that approach, it's better to go over your answer. Next question is, it is given that x raised to power 4 plus 1 by x raised to power 4 is equal to 23. X raised to power 4 plus 1 by x raised to power 4 equal to 23. I need x minus 1 by x, right? For that, first of all, I need x square plus 1 by x square. Add 2 here, add 2 here. So, you can say x square plus 1 by x square equal to 5. That's the first thing. Now I need x minus 1 by x. So what I have to take? Subtract 2 from here and 2 from here. So I can say x square plus 1 by x square minus 2 into my x into 1 by x equal to 3. Now this is x minus 1 by x whole square equal to 3. Right? Now from here I can say x minus 1 by x. From here what I can say that, because I have subtracted here 2, because I have to find, I find that value, this is equal to 3, hence I can say 4th is my answer. Next question is, it is given that ABC are the 3 non-zero real numbers such that A plus B plus C equal to 0. That is given to us, A plus B plus C equal to 0. We have to find the value of this expression, right? Now, what I advise for this type of question, that assume any number from your side. That's it's a better choice, right? How? Let us say although it's a better choice, what you can say, just take any number from your side and then you have to put it and then you try to solve it. For example, we say A plus B plus C equal to 0. So let us say A equal to 1, B equal to 2 and C equal to minus 3. That you can say. Right? Now, put here 1 plus 4 plus 9 divided by 4, and if I just multiply CA, that is said to be plus 3. 9 plus 4, 13, 14 by 7, my answer is said to be 2. Hence, I can say second is my answer. Now, that's a better choice. If you go with any formula sometime in your mind, you are not able to project a formula. In that case, if you go by just taking any value, what you have to just check that, you have to take a value that satisfies it, right? Once it satisfies it, there we can answer it. Hence, I can say answer is said to be 2. Let us have the next question. It's a basic question of making factorization. What is given to us? A square plus AB plus B square equal to 4. And here it is given that A raised to power 4 plus A square B square plus B raised to power 4 equal to 8. What I can say, A raised to power 4 plus 2A square B square plus B raised to power 4 minus A square B square equal to 8. Now, this is A square plus B square whole square minus AB square equal to 8. So what I can say, A square plus B square plus AB, and here I can say A square plus B square minus AB, this is equal to 8, right? Now, it is given that this value is equal to 4, hence this value must be 2. So I can say that A square plus B square minus AB is equal to 2, and we have A square plus B square plus AB equal to 4. I have to find AB, subtract, right? This is cancelled out. So I can say minus 2AB is equal to minus 2, or else I can say AB equal to 1, right? Hence I can say 4th is my answer, value of AB is equal to 1. Let us have the next question here. If x equal to 3 plus 2 root 2, we have to find that value, right? What I can say, first I will find root x. Root x is said to be under root of 3 plus 2 root 2, just completion of square that we have studied in thirds and indices, that is root 2 plus 1 whole square. So I can say this is root 2 plus 1, okay? So my answer will be root 2 plus 1 minus 1 by root 2 plus 1, okay? Now, multiply by root 2 minus 1 divided by root 2 minus 1. So this would be taken as root 2 plus 1 minus, here I can say root 2 minus 1 divided by 2 minus 1, 1. Okay, so I can say root 2 plus 1 minus root 2 plus 1, right? This is cancelled out. Hence, I can say my final answer is said to be 2. Second becomes my answer. The value of root x minus 1 by root x is equal to 2. Next question is, A is given as 23, B is given as minus 29. We have to find the value of 25A square plus 40AB plus 16B square. Right? When I observe it, 5A square plus 2 into 5A into 4B plus 4B whole square. Right? This is 5A plus 4B whole square. Right? Now we have the value of A and B. A is 23, put here 115, B is 29, minus 4 into 29. We know that 4 into 29 is 116, so I am getting minus 1 raised to power 2, 1 becomes my answer. So hence I can say answer to this question is said to be 1. This is the end to our algebraic identities session number 3. I hope you enjoyed the session. Thank you very much. I expect you to share these videos with your friends on your Facebook wall so that more and more students will be benefited by this. Thank you.